Chapter 5, Principles of Inheritance and Variation. This is video number 4, in which we will be studying about mutation, pedigree analysis, and Mendelian and chromosomal disorder. So, what is mutation? Sudden change in DNA sequence is known as mutation. Any change. Now, if that change is heritable, then the mutation will cause an effect in the genotype as well as the phenotype of an organism. And then it will lead to variation. Now, this mutation may be caused due to some chemical or physical factors. They are known as mutagens. Now, this mutagens can induce mutation. Even UV rays can also cause mutations. Basically, there are two types of mutation, point mutation and frame shift mutation. Mutation that occurs due to change in the single base pair of the DNA. That is called point mutation. That is seen in sickle cell anemia, and this we will be studying also. And when there is a deletion or insertion of a base pair of a DNA, either the base pair is deleted or added, then you call it as a frame shift mutation. Now let's come to pedigree analysis. What is pedigree analysis? It's the analysis of the traits in several generations of a family. And this inheritance of that particular trait is represented by a family tree over the generations. Let us look at the symbols used in the pedigree analysis. If it's a square, it represents male. If it's a circle, it represents female. If these square and circle is shaded, then it represents that these individuals are affected. They are carrying a disease. If there is a line between a square and a circle, this shows mating. And this shows that the offsprings are given birth. Two generations. One is the parent generation, where you can see the two cursor. And the second generation is the offspring. If it's in a joined in a triangle form, it's identical twins, and only in the form of an inverted V, then that is a non-identical twins. Now let's talk about Mendelian disorder. Now these Mendelian disorders are caused by the mutation affecting single gene. One single gene is affected or a base pair is affected. More than 4,500 disorders are listed under Mendelian disorder. Now, these disorders can be categorized as autosomal dominant, autosomal recessive, or X-linked inheritance. If the gene, that is defective gene, is present in the autosome, then it is an autosomal disease. And if that gene is present on the X-linked X chromosome, then it's an X-linked inheritance. If that allele or the gene is dominant, then autosomal dominant, otherwise it's autosomal recessive. We all know that each gene is represented by a pair of allele on a specific locus on the corresponding chromosome. One of the common Mendelian disorders is hemophilia. It's also known as a bleeder's disease. And it is a sex-linked recessive disease. In this, the patient blood does not clot. This is because a single protein in the cascade of protein involved in clotting is affected. And a single cut may result in non-stop bleeding. Now, as it is a sex-linked recessive disease, in this heterozygous female is a carrier. like this is a carrier woman, X, X, H. A carrier woman will never transmit the disease to its daughter. Carrier woman will transmit the disease to the son. The daughter can only get hemophilic, or the female can become hemophilic only when the male or the father is hemophilic. But as we know, that father being hemophilic is and viable to that age is little difficult. Next comes autosomal recessive disease, sickle cell anemia. This is an autosomal recessive trait. It can be transmitted from parents to offspring when both the parents are carrier. The disease is controlled by a single pair of allele, that is HBA, HBS. If it is HBS, HBS, homozygous, then it shows a diseased phenotype. A heterozygous individual with HBA, HBS shows normal phenotype. They are the carriers. And in this defect, this defect is caused due to the substitution of glutamic acid by valine in the sixth position of beta globin chain of the hemoglobin molecule. It results from single base substitution from GAG to GUG. So it's a point mutation, children. Here, one single base pair gets changed. This A is changed to U at the sixth codon of the beta globin. Now, due to this, the mutant hemoglobin is formed, and under low oxygen tension, the shape of the RBC changes from biconcave to sickle cell. I would like to tell you one thing over here, that the sickles, the person who was suffering from sickle cell anemia, they generally do not suffer from malaria. Because in chapter 8, you must have studied that the malaria, the protozoan, the plasmodium, it develops in the RBC. Now, because the RBC is sickle shaped, it does not develop. So, generally, the person those who are sickle, suffering from sickle shaped anemia do not suffer from malaria. Now, let's come to the chromosomal disorder. The chromosomal disorder is due to the absence or excess of abnormal arrangement of one or more chromosomes. It is of two types, aneuploidy and polyploidy. Aneuploidy is failure of segregation of chromatid during cell division cycle and results in gain or loss of chromosome. And polyploidy, it is due to failure of cytokinesis before telophase state of cell division and results in an increase in whole set of chromosome in an organism. One of the common diseases of chromosomal disorder is Down syndrome. In this, there is an extra a copy of chromosome number 21. So it's a trisomy, 2N plus 1. The affected individual is having small round head, furrowed tongue, partially open mouth, broad palm with characteristic palm creases. Physical, psychomotor, and mental development is retarded. Another chromosomal disorder, other two chromosomal disorders are Turner syndrome and Klinefelter syndrome. Turner syndrome is a loss of X chromosome in human female, so it is 45. Plus exo. It's an exo type of a disease. Such females are sterile with ovaries are rudimentary And in Klinefelter's, the karyotype is 47, that's just XXY. Such females are also sterile and they have male characteristics.